Hello again. I have here one of my projects that I just finished. So this is mosaic CD DVDs on canvas and represents kind of creature angel that it's sitting on a stone in the middle of nowhere. It's a fantasy subject. You can use it in this way if you wish to do it in my way, or you can just use your own imagination and you can create something similar that is going to work very well or on any of the walls that you're having in your home. So here, as you can see, I have used just here and there the CDs and DVDs, the cuts. And as you can see, the way that I'm moving are changing the color as well. So it's such a diverse and fulfilling way that you can look at this kind of work. And it's going to just give you a lot of satisfaction. You'll see step by step the way that I have created this piece. It's not hard at all to do it, and I'm encouraging you, if you have any desire to create on your own this kind of project, or you have time, or you want to try something new, definitely you can do it. You can use a geometrical design, or you can have a print from a picture or a photograph, whatever fits you the best. So you can just spend a little bit time using the steps that I'm going to show you, and definitely you can do this kind of artwork by yourself. It's a very light kind of mosaic that you can use on your walls without having any danger to be like in you have kids or pets that they are going to just be around. They will be very safe using this type of mosaic. It's very light, as I said, and can be very versatile to do it on your own. Can be done on smaller pieces or very, very large pieces, or some pieces put the, like the canvases, put them together and then create a large spot of light and colors on your wall. So showing you step by step, I'm hoping that you'll be able to do it, or you'll wish to do it and try it on your own, and for sure it's going to look absolutely great. I've started to paint the canvas that it's 2 by 3 feet, and you'll see here that I've used like a very pale blue color for the background at the top side, and a little bit a mixture of yellow and a little bit blue to create the base for the subject. And after that, on top, I have drawn the subject, and as you can see, is this kind of an angel earth creature. And I will fill up the wings with the CDs, and with the for the rest of the body I'm going to paint it and create the shadows that I need to highlight the piece. So step by step I will finish this piece, and I'm hoping that it's going to look exactly the way that I've imagined. At this point my project looks like in this way. So I have combined yellow, white, a little bit of blue And I've got those kind of colors, and of course a little bit of brown. And I've created kind of the shape of my entity that I'm trying to reflect here on this canvas. I can continue to go more for more details regarding the body, the wings, the background, the stones that the creature stays on, but I wish to use some CDs or DVDs, and I will just cut them and use them to fill up the wings and parts of the body here to reflect even more that this creature is a special one, as I'm thinking in my mind. For this part of the project, you can just use some of the leftover CDs or DVDs that are not useful for you anymore. Cut pieces out of them and just try to attach them to the desired place on your project. You can use like a glue, which I have here, which is transparent glue, or you can use silicone. That works well as well. Now, at this part of the project, you can use the CDs or DVDs, or if you wish to incorporate some beads as well, or any other elements that you have which are not heavy, you can do it as you wish. It's very important to remember that this piece is going to hang on a wall, and even if it's going to show like it's a mosaic, it cannot be very heavy because, of course, it's removable, and also it's very easy to be pushed a little bit and come out from the hook, or can be dangerous if you have something underneath and you don't want to have any problems with this type of project. So please remember all the time that when you are using this type of media, it's going to be very light. You cannot use ceramic or any other kind of tiles that are heavy, and the entire project becomes very heavy for the wall, and it's not safe to be placed on any of the walls in your house. So to get this impression that you are having still a mosaic, I'm using this kind of plastic parts from the CDs or DVDs that are going to increase greatly the way that the project looks, and in the same time are very, very light. So no worries that the entire canvas can be placed on a hook and is going to ruin the wall. Absolutely no worries. So in this way, you'll have both the very good, nice look for the project, and in the same time, very safe as well. So I will continue to fill up the desired parts from my project with the CDs and DVDs, and maybe I'm thinking for other kind of beads or anything that I can use, which are again light pieces that I can attach to my canvas, and I will see the way that goes. I will use my imagination to continue this type of project. So let's see the way that is going to look further. I have cut some pieces out from this DVD, and I have used the glue, as I said, the transparent one, and I have attached some pieces here and there on my creature exactly the way that I wanted to imagine that is going to look like. So when you are using the CDs or DVDs, like pieces out of them, then you can arrange the pieces in a little bit better display for the eye. So don't just place them randomly on your project. You can do that, of course, but it will be better if you can use the shape of the cut and place it exactly where you need it the most. So for here, you see that I've used the end of the DVD, that it's round, and I try to place them in the way that will suggest that the feather looks on the wing. So I will try to reflect kind of as many feathers as I can and give this impression that the design flows exactly in the way that I was thinking. Of course, you just don't need to do this, but it's better if you can do it, because overall, at the end, the piece is going to look even better. So here for the knee, that it's curved, I have used exactly the same round cuts from the DVDs, and I try to place them one after another to give the impression that it's a natural move for the knee. So if you have CDs that are different, or DVDs that are different color, they have different coloration, you can use this as well. As you can see here, some of them are a little bit darker and other ones lighter, of course, and you just create this sensation of the shadow that comes from the drape of the cover for this creature in my, as I said, in my project here. Now I will continue to highlight now the body, the face, the hand that holds the head here that I have it, and see the way further the project looks for the finish look of course as well. This is my finish look of my project, and as you can see, it shows this creature that it's resting on a stone in the middle of nowhere, and that is because I wanted to just focus all the attention to the creature itself. So as you can see, the CDs and DVDs that I have used for this project were helping me a lot, and again I was using the shape of the cuts to create this feeling that the entire design flows. So as you can see, for the wings, for the feathers, and here for the rest of the body that I covered here and there with the cuts of DVDs and CDs, are working well together. For the parts that I didn't use the cuts, I have used the paint, and that creates more details for the subject itself. So you'll have this feeling that the subject detaches from the rest of the painting. So you will see that on the wall it's going to create a better look, and it's going to just enhance the place where you'll hang this kind of project. Overall, I'm very happy with the way that looks, and was absolutely a very good time for me to spend in this way. Focused my imagination and my thoughts during this project to create this subject. So I'm just thinking that each of you that are trying to do this kind of project is going to be a benefic way to spend the time during this project. So if you are interested in more of my other subjects that I have used, or any other ways that I can spend my time regarding gardening, or any other cement projects, or I have the mosaic as well, or ceramic projects, you can just check on my channel. And if you have any questions, as always, I will be more than happy to get back to you with any information that you are looking for regarding my projects. This is a very good way for you to have something to do on your own, and definitely for sure you have some spare CDs, DVDs in your house, or you can get them from your friends or relatives, and they can be used in this way for your project. This, as I said, it's a very light way of making a mosaic, and it's going to just give you a very, very good look for the place where you'll use it. I'm hoping that for you, as always, was an inspiration, my work. So I'm hoping that you are well as well. Thank you so much for taking your time and watching this video. I'm wishing you all the best. Thank you. Goodbye.